So this is the register for the clock configuration. As you can see, there are options for PLL and USB prescaler and so on and so on, but we are not gonna deal with them today because we are just gonna use GPIO to pull it low or high. So this is not in use today. So let's go to another register for the peripherals. Yeah, here one thing is required, that the system clock switch, it selects system clock as HSI, HSE or PLL. So we are gonna use HSE. So here we will write in this bit 1 to 0, we will write 01. This will select our HSE as system clock. That's it. And this is our register for the APB2, peripheral clock enable register. Here we will enable clock for the our peripheral, which is the GPIO-C. So this is our IO port C enable bit, which is in this register. It is the fourth bit. So if I write 1 to this bit, it will enable clock for the GPIO-C. And our next register will be port configuration registers. So let's go there. So this is my port configuration registers. As you can see, these are 32 bit registers and these are using 2 bits for the particular pin. So my pin is pin number 13. So this is the port configuration register low. So it uses 4 bits. One is mode, 2 for mode and 2 for configuration. So here only starting 8 pin configuration is there in this register. So I have to go to the GPIO XCRH, which is the port configuration register high. So I guess it will be the next one. Yeah, this one. So I have to deal with the configuration for pin number 13 and mode for pin number 13. So here if I write 10 in the mode, then it will be pull up or pull down, and in configuration, but I have to use it in output mode, so I'll write general purpose output, or I will use general purpose output push pull. So I don't need to write anything in this, I think. No, I need to write because the reset value is something else, so I have to explicitly write to 0 to 0 0 to these pins bits. And this is the mode. So here I will select maximum speed as 10 megahertz. So let's go to our code. So this is my code. As you can see, this is the control register offset. This is the configuration register offset. This is the APB2 ENR offset, which enables the GPIO-C peripheral. And this is my output data register. The output data registers are registers. If you write anything to those registers, it will reflect on the ports. So if I write on the 13th bit of ODR as 1, then it will turn on my LED. And the IDR is the input data register, which used in the as if you are using any GPIO in input mode. The CRH we are using in this, and bit set reset register. Today we are may not gonna use it, but later on it will be required. So if I add base with the offset, then I'll go to that particular address space, or I would say I'll get that particular address. So that I have done here. I have added with the base and the offset, base and the offset, so I'll get the CFGR register APB2 because it comes in the address space of RCC, so that's why it has been done add with the RCC base. Here are my port mode registers for the port, so we are going to use these as we are going to use GPIOC. So here I have defined a pointer which points to the particular memory, or if I write any address to the X, it will reflect to that memory, and a small delay function for the blinking calculations, and this is my main. So as I have explained earlier, I am just enabling bit number 16 for that RCCCR register. Let's open that again. So this is my RCCCR register. So if I write 1 to this bit, then it will select external clock, which was the 8 MHz crystal on board. And then I'm just polling for the 17th bit. If it is on, then I'm doing the CFGR configuration and I'm writing 1 to the 0th bit. So this is the CFGR register. So if I write 1, then first bit, yeah. Now it is the same register, yeah, this one. So on the 0th bit, if I write 1 here, then it will do. It will select HSES system clock. So now I have selected the system clock for the controller. Let's go ahead. Let's go to APB to ENR register. So here I have enabled clock for bit number 3, 2, and 4. So bit number 2 is GPIO A, bit number 3 is GPIO B, and bit number 4 is GPIO C. So I have enabled clock for the 3 ports, but even if I don't write for the B and A, it will work because we just want clock for the GPIO C for this case. And then we are selecting the mode for the particular port. So let's go to these registers.